Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
The fun part of the job is working with the designers. We get to see, you know, their ideas and their new concepts. My name is Nina Tortosa. I am an aerodynamicist at General Motors, and my job is to make vehicles more fuel efficient by reducing drag. I come in and take a studio surface. It gets milled onto a third scale model, and we put it in the wind tunnel. Standing in the wind tunnel here. We're standing inside the General Motors Aerodynamics Laboratory, and what you see behind me is our fan that powers the air. It has a 43-foot diameter. It's a closed-circuit wind tunnel. Aerodynamics is important because it's the single most cost-effective way of increasing fuel economy. By making the vehicle more aerodynamic, you're making it more efficient and easier to cut through the air.
Aerodynamics in terms of production vehicles can mean very slippery. So the car has low drag. So the car goes through the air slipperier, cleaner, can add miles to the gallon in terms of how far you can drive. Aerodynamics also mean quiet inside the car, because anything that sticks out of a car creates turbulence and creates noise.
Aerodynamics are probably more important for a vehicle that wants to get good fuel economy than it is for a vehicle that wants to go fast. Because fuel economy is all about efficiency.
My degree is in aerospace engineering, and an aerodynamicist works on aerodynamic performance, whether it's a vehicle or an aircraft or boats. I'm a private pilot, so I fly Piper Warriors. You get a different perspective on the world when you're high above and you see everybody as little tiny ants. It's a different feeling, and I like to go sailing. Those are kind of the things that drew me towards aerospace engineering and ultimately to working on vehicles here. Right now I'm working on the Chevy Volt. It has some very aggressive aero targets. It's been fun trying to take the studio ideas and their styling and their surface and try and make it more aerodynamic.
But we've spent a lot of time in the wind tunnel tuning these surfaces, getting the rounded corner in the front so that the air has minimal disturbance as it goes around the corner. Every count of drag, as we call it, means I can't go as far on pure battery power.
We've changed it quite a bit from what was shown as a concept, but it has some features in there that are there for aerodynamic performance, and it's not something you see very often. So that's kind of exciting to be able to see the car and say, look, we did that for aero.
We're looking at things that are unique and different in aero, where we take the grill and the grill actually closes up and makes it a flush front of the car, which is good aero-wise, but we have to balance it to cool the car.
We get to discuss what looks good and what works aerodynamically, and they're not always the same thing. A lot of times it pulls us in different directions, and so we have to compromise or we have to find an alternative that still meets what they want to achieve with a certain look and what I need to achieve with the drag.
We're looking at components in the rear of the car, which we call active aero, where it'll have a spoiler that can lift and move, and actually maybe even flaps on the taillights that kind of flip out like a plane, because the squarer the back of the car gets, the better the car is.
Trying to balance aerodynamic performance with the design has been an amazing experience. I've learned a lot from design and how they view vehicles and how they think about them. And I think they learn quite a bit on what makes a vehicle aerodynamic.
Some of the aero things can be really cool. I mean, they could provide a sense of drama, a sense of theater in the car. That when you see it driving down the freeway, certain things start happening and people can see it around you. And it kind of telegraphs about the technology of the car. That, wow, look what that car is doing. Things are moving on. Isn't that neat?
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more Press Pass coverage, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.